I'm Brad Avery with BevNet. We're here at NACS 2019 in Atlanta, Georgia. I'm with Todd Gibson, the founder and CEO of Yerba, a sparkling water made with yerba mate. Todd, thank you for being here.
Brad, thanks for having me.
So you launched in 2017, and you're now looking at 8,000 stores and counting. Can you tell me a little bit about your growth in this time?
I mean, this year we did eclipse the 8,000 store mark. We've had some fantastic partners that came on with us. We launched this year with Wawa, Circle K, in various regions around the country, mostly within our strategic strike zone. Mostly West Coast, a little bit East Coast, and a little bit Northern Midwest have been like our key strategic zones that we've been focusing on.
Where is the opportunity for a brand like this, in particular, given that sparkling water is such a hot category?
So sparkling's pretty underdeveloped in C-store. Like, you go into a grocery store and there's a healthy development of sparkling, as we all know, with the trends going with LaCroix and Bubbly and others. In C-store, it's still a shelf, maybe a shelf and a half in C-store. So there's still a lot of room for development. But what we found for the opportunity for us is taking the enhanced sparkling water and expanding that within that sparkling water space gives us an opportunity to really have a good point of differentiation, gives us that opportunity to speak to the consumer where they're looking to be spoken to, right, in a format that they're looking for. So we're really excited about it.
The yerba mate play has given you this leg up in C-store, energy, caffeine. How is that impacting your play in the category?
Well, for us, it gives us a competitive advantage within that sparkling water space. Right now, if you're in the water door, it's either plain sparkling water or it's plain still water, where for us, we're the first functional sparkling water that we've brought to the marketplace, and we have that first mover advantage within these C-stores. We feel very comfortable in that position right now. And we're looking for the aggressive growth going into 2020.
Talking a bit about aggressive growth, how does C-Store continue to play a role there? Because you have an omni-channel strategy.
We do. We have an omni-channel strategy, but at the same time, what we have noticed is that within the C-Store space specifically, it's turning some of our best VPOs that we have in the nation, and it's only a natural to continue to grow where your product is being received the best in the market. So it doesn't mean that we're not doing well in grocery. We are doing very well in grocery, but C-store VPOs are just turning faster than any other market that we're in currently.
Right, and I think also in sort of the energy space as well, we're seeing innovation towards cleaner energy, no sugar. Do you find yourself competing against the big monster Red Bulls, or do you find yourself living in a different part of the store?
So far, thankfully, we're living in a different part of the store, so we're not lumped in with the clutter. But the reality is there's a lot of incredibly smart companies that are here on this show floor that are getting smarter on their positioning of their brand. And I think that new, natural, healthy energy category is going to become a very, very much a thing in C-store. Right, you'll still have your Monster doors, your Red Bull doors, your Bang, your C4, but now there's also this new evolution of health and wellness, and there's a handful of great companies that are making a good play, and I see that becoming a very big category.
So for you, in order to stay competitive, one thing that you're doing is you're offering a packaging refresh. Could you talk a little bit about that?
Sure. We're just bringing more color. So if you remember on the package, it's very chalkboard. Mm-hmm. It's dark. It feels very premium as a package. But the reality is, to speak to this mainstream consumer, we need to be more bright, vibrant, very colorful, stimulating to the eye as well as to the palate. The reality is yerba mate isn't known coast to coast. Mm-hmm. If you're on the West Coast, people know what yerba mate is. If you're in Chicago, they know what it is. New York, there's a good chance they know, but maybe not. Mm-hmm. Right? But you get to the central part of the United States, the Southeast, yerba mate is not a known entity yet. So it's still developing.
And when can we expect to see this on shelves?
We'll be on shelf in April 2020 with all of our new packaging.
And from there, where do you plan to go next? If your distribution is growing at such a clip, you know, how do you plan to keep that up in 2020?
So we see further expansion within the Northern Midwest, up in the Northeast, and the West Coast. So there's a lot of chains that we're not in. When you're in 8,000 stores, I mean, you could really have that just in L.A., right?
Yeah.
With how many stores are there. So there's so much room to grow within the current markets that we're in. But we do see a strong expansion down in like the Austin, Houston, San Antonio market for us in 2020 as well. It's another strong yerba mate territory.
Well, Todd, thank you so much for being here with us.
Brad, thank you for having me. I really appreciate it.
And we'll have much more coming from NACS soon. As you can hear, it's quite a party here. So please stay tuned. We'll be right back.